Once upon a time, there was a little green engine who worked on a little railway. At first, he was an eager, bouncy fellow who was determined to work. But his bounciness led to carelessness, and he became a show-off. He rode roughly and often came off the rails. Others warned him to be careful, but he took no notice. December on the island of Sodor. There was no snow this year, but the engines were still working as hard as ever. Everyone was traveling to be with their families and friends for the holidays. Christmas was approaching, and the engines were all excited as ever. The Skarloey Railway was busy too, especially on Christmas Day, which was not the case for the Northwestern Railway. This year, a group of members from a railway society were coming to write a book about every engine of Sodor. Five of the men were to specialize in the narrow gauge railways and would be visiting the Koldyfell and Skarloey railways. All the engines were excited to have a biography written about each of them, as well as a photograph pasted in the pages.
I'll have the longest biography. I've had many interesting adventures in my life.
Rubbish! I've had a larger impact on this railway than any of you. Yes, quite a negative impact, if you ask me. Just shut your face!
You three probably won't be in the book if you keep acting this way.
Exactly. Now, isn't it time you got your train ready, Peter Sam?
Oh, yes, of course, sir.
There were so many passengers that Peter Sam needed help from Sir Handel to pull his train. The coaches were stuffed, and they complained all the way.
We're too full! We're going to burst! We're going to burst!
So are our ears!
At the last station, they met Bertram, who smiled so much that it was often creepy.
These coaches were complaining like heck.
I know they need kindness, but sometimes I just want to bump them off the rails if they don't behave.
Oh, my dear little Sir Handel, the only things you should bump are trucks, and even they need a little compassion. Empathy is always important, you know. Sure, they act out, but they could have come from bad yards, had difficult childhoods, or perhaps they had a lack of a real father figure, which could have forced them to embark on a life of perpetual mischief and crime.
Trucks need no compassion. They're careless and stupid by nature. Idiotic morons are being jerks.
It can also be the engine pulling the trucks that is careless. Now I'm off to do my jobs. Ta-ta!
I remember, there was a careless engine on our old line.
There were lots of careless engines, Peter Sam. Lots of them indeed.
But don't you remember? He was behind our shed. He was a very reckless engine, so they turned him into a barbecue or something like that.
Oh, you mean Splatter? Or was it Grudger? No, wait, Scrooge.
It was something like that. I'll have to ask Grandpa. I wonder what happened to him when the line closed down, or if he was even there when the line was closed down.
The day soon came when the Railway Society arrived. All the engines were smartened up for their photographs.
Now this is how you take a photograph, boys.
Yes, but my section will have more than 5 times the amount of text that yours will. I'm an inspiration.
Inspiration? You failed miserably when you first arrived.
But I overcame it and had one of the most successful rebuilds ever. Pah!
The narrow gauge enthusiasts first went to the Coldy Fell Railway, which was normally closed for the winter, but today the engines gave him private rides.
I don't see the point in all this. Why are we being exploited?
You think Patrick would be pleased to have his photo in a book, wouldn't you, Eric?
Quite so, Alaric, being the hot-haired one.
Right, off we go!
The Railway Society was very impressed.
Mr. Brian has certainly got a wonderful railway here.
Indeed he does. Anything else you'd like to know about us?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I am very curious about it. Is there an engine with the number 1 on this railway? I saw numbers 2 through 8, but not a number 1. What happened?
Oh, we did have a number 1, but not long after the railway opened. He, had a terrible accident and was never repaired.
Dear Lord! Please tell me, Coldy.
His name was Godred, named after the king. This probably made him extremely arrogant, and he was very reckless. One day, he was coming down the mountain too fast. No one was hurt, but he was severely damaged. The manager said that they had no money to mend him, so he was put at the back of the shed. There's a rumor that the manager used his parts to mend us, but our manager would never be that cruel. Instead, he was scrapped because he became a waste of space.
Good Lord! That is tragic! Oh well, I guess that is quite a terrible mistake we must never make.
Exactly. Though I must say, I feel quite a bit of sorrow for the chap.
Good tidings, fine engine. Who might you be?
I'm Neil. Have we met before?
I'm Bertram, the old warrior, and I think we have met, actually, back in 1941 on the 13th of September.
How the hell do you remember that?
It was not long before the Mid-Sodor Railway closed. You came to Arlesborough Station one day, and I remember because you were a very unique-looking engine.
Yes, I did. You do have an unusually comprehensible memory, Barty?
Bertram! It's Bertram, my fine fellow! Anyway, I better be off. Nice meeting you again, Neil, the Sodor and Mainland Railways number 2.
Uniqueness or awkwardness? I can't decide.
I find it so odd that he can remember how many blocks of coal he took on a specific day years ago, yet he doesn't remember how he got to this railway.
The next day, the Railway Society arrived on a special train pulled by Stanley.
Here we are! Groovage Gate, my friends!
They're here!
Look sharp, everybody!
The men were soon all interviewing the engines.
I was called Stewart at first, but it sounded awkward, so I changed it when I came here.
I'm actually named after my builders, Rustin and Hornsby, not my orange color.
Fascinating!
The men were especially interested in Duke and his adventures. Duke had a sore throat, but was still willing to talk.
What exactly did you do when you were in that shed for over 20 years?
Well, I spent most of the time when I was awake. I talked to myself, actually. I was alone so long that I almost became 2 inches in the body of one, if you know what I mean.
It's a good thing they found you when they did. Indeed. I have a question, Duke. We were looking through the records of all the engines on the Mid-Sodor Railway. We found out what happened to the engines, either where they were sent afterwards or if they were scrapped. But we came across one interesting engine who apparently was turned into a generator. And the records never said what happened to him after the railway closed down. So he must still be there or... Well, do you know what happened?
I assume you're talking about Smudger.
Yes, we are. Beta Sam. That was his name. Smudger.
Oh yes, of course. Now I remember.
Well, I myself do not know what happened. Neither did our magic.
What do you mean?
You see, one day Smudger was there, and later was gone. He just disappeared. We suspected that he had been scrapped, but the magic did not have any knowledge about it. Therefore, he was either stolen or simply you. He may have just been moved somewhere.
The men all stared at Duke. You mean he just disappeared without a trace?
Pretty much.
When did this happen?
About 1926 or 27.
I see. Gentlemen, I am very fascinated by this. We will definitely add a section about this engine to our books.
You could go visit the Arlesdale Railway. That line runs on what used to be the Mid-Sodor Railway.
Really? We know about that railway. In fact, we were hoping to visit it. I guess we will be going there next. Nice talking to you, Duke. Hope your throat gets better. We'll be back tomorrow.
Goodbye, Mr. Berkeley.
I do remember seeing him behind the shed. Then he just disappeared.
I'm glad we listened to Duke and didn't end up like him.
Who'll be pulling the special train, sir?
I have decided to give that job to Rex.
Whoa, missed opportunity here, people. You're totally missing out on my bodacious hunk of metal right here. Why Rex? Why not me?
Rex's work has been outstanding these past couple of weeks. You, on the other hand, may have developed a negative reputation after that incident at the watermill last week.
It was those blasted coaches' fault. They pushed me. The nerve of some people. They're all jealous. I'm hot. They're not. They just need to deal with it. Tweet it, folks. Hashtag Molten Mike.
Yeah, sure. That's likely.
We'll be waiting to welcome them to our railway.
I think they'll be creeped out by your simultaneous dialogue.
That's what makes us unique.
I think you'll be quite fascinated with the little engines at Arlesdale.
Yes, indeed. They're basically toy trains.
I remember riding on a toy-like train on the Ravenglass and Eskdale Railway in England. Well, as a matter of fact, these little engines are their brothers. Splendid! Take us away, Duck.
Do you know anything about this engine they're looking for?
Nope, never heard of it.
Bertram, I want you to work at the slate quarry today. There's important work that needs to be done there.
Yes, sir. Come on, driver. Let's go and push some trucks up the incline.
Well, I've certainly never seen the remains of a narrow-gauge engine here, unless you count Duke.
Where exactly did you find Duke?
Oh, we didn't exactly find him on our line. The line doesn't quite reach the old Mid-Sodor sheds, so the men had to go on foot. Shall I drop you off at the road that leads you there? It's like a 5-minute walk.
Yes, please.
Ah, the wonderful smell of slate. Isn't it great?
Oh, shut up. Here it is. The sheds of the Mid-Sodor Railway.
There's no engine here, Brackley.
There may be one buried. I think we should ask if we could borrow some digging equipment.
I found something, Charles. Looks like a piston of some sort.
A piston? That might be something, John. Does it give any hint of who it was attached to?
Nope. It's too rusty to tell even what color it was.
Come on, lads. Let's get you up the incline.
No, get away from us, you moron!
many trucks is he pushing up?
Let's see. He's pushing up 10! That's way over the limit! Wait a minute. We've pushed too many trucks up. Oh, crap.
Don't fret, driver. I'm sure it'll be fine.
But it wasn't. The winch groaned from the weight. Bertram was too dopey to realize this. The trucks were almost at the top when the cable snapped. Bertram, look out!
Confusion.
This is dreadfully smelling.
Ghost! It's the ghost!
What ghost?
It's the old warrior! He's come
to hunt me down!
Feeble!
He's awake, everyone!
Oh, dear Lord, what happened?
You pushed too many trucks up the incline. They banged your head up pretty bad.
Here, let me help you back to the shed.
I'm very sorry, sir. I must have been too enthused to know what I was doing.
It's all right, Bertram. I'm just glad you're okay. Let's just say it's probably a good idea to obey the rules. Now, I better be going. You just get some rest.
Goodbye, sir.
You know, I had the same exact thing happen to me. My funnel was damaged, and that's where I got my new one.
I'm actually feeling a lot better. Trust me, I had an accident way worse than this back in the day.
When was this? Please, tell us.
It was the first time I came to the railway. Back in 1929, I think.
1929? Bertram, you came to the railway in 1998.
And what do you mean, first time? Have you been here before?
Why, yes. Scarlowe and Reneas, don't you remember?
No, we don't even know what you're talking about.
Wait a minute. No. It can't be. It just cannot be.
What, Reneas?
1929 is around the time when the privately owned engine arrived on the railway. You know, the engine that, well...
Fell off the bridge? Reneas, that was a tank engine. Unless... Hang on. He was brown just like Bertram, and he had a similar face. Bertram, are you saying that you were the tank engine who fell off the bridge?
Yes, of course. That's the accident I was referring to.
The engines were all silent.
You've been with us for 16 years now. How did you not once mention that?
I don't know. In fact, before the accident, I didn't even remember it. I must have developed a state of amnesia when I fell off the bridge, and then the blow from the trucks must have restored all of my lost memories.
Just tell us what happened on that night. We're all dying to find out.
Very well, then. I arrived on the Scarlowe Railway back in 1927, but I was a different engine indeed. I was a little brown tank engine owned by the quarry. Back then, the slate quarry was privately owned, and I was the engine who worked there. Since I was always busy at the quarry, I hardly ever saw Scarlowe and Reneas. I remember thinking how marvelous they looked in their bright red coats.
Yep!
It was October 15th, 1929, I think.
Bertram, I want you to take these slate guys to the transfer yards tonight. You can leave them here and pick them up in the morning.
Yes, sir.
Who knows, we may see the red engines again.
Splendid. And sure enough, I did see one of you. I think it was Reneas. He whistled hello, but I was too shy to respond. It was very late when I arrived at the transfer yards with the trucks. A standard gauge engine was waiting to collect the slate. However, as soon as I set off, there was a snap, and then a clang. My coupling rods had come loose, and they were dangling on the track.
Are you sure it's safe to proceed home?
Of course it is. Who cares anyway? We'll be fine.
But we wouldn't. The driver and fireman had gone to a party the night before and had too much to drink. They were singing loudly until we reached the old iron bridge. And from what I recall, I believe it was Earth, Wind, and Fire September, but don't quote me on that. Actually, that hardly makes any sense because that hit the charts in 1978. Anyway, going over it with a dangling coupling rod was the act that ended the driver and fireman's lives. We were about halfway across when the rods got caught in the bridge. It swept us over the side, and we plunged into the swamps below. I regained consciousness at Croven's Gate Works, a completely different engine after being rebuilt. I was then shipped to the Mid-Sodor Railway.
But how?
The men searched in the ravine, but never found an engine.
From what I was told, some workmen snooping around found me in the swampy water about a day after I had fallen. They were from the Mid-Sodor Railway, and took me to Croven's Gate. They needed a new engine, so I was to be rebuilt and sent to the Mid-Sodor line to work. But apparently, they forgot to tell the Scarlowy Railway controller, and his workmen searched the day afterwards but only found the driver and fireman.
Did they survive? After falling about 300 feet? Doubtfully.
He's right. Both of them died instantly. The workmen who found me didn't want to handle the dead bodies, so they left them there, where they were found the next day.
The engines were all silent. The mystery of the old iron bridge had finally been solved. Scarlowy smiled.
I'm just so glad that you survived. We can no longer be haunted by the case of the old iron bridge.
The engines all whistled in delight. They were relieved, especially Duncan, who could now cross the bridge without worrying about ghosts.
Well, we found out a fun fact today. What happened before you arrived on the Scarlowy Railway? Like, where were you built?
I don't like to talk about it.
Why not?
Because I don't remember it. Yes, I don't remember where I was built or how I came from this railway. Now I think I'd better get back to the quarry.
Where are you going? You still need to recover, Bertram.
What's he all steamed up about?
We just found out something very interesting about our old Bertram.
Hello, Rex. Did they find anything?
We found a lot of rusty wheels and beat-up slate cars, but no engine.
Were they looking for a specific engine?
Yes, they were. A little green engine called Smudger, I think. Have you heard of him?
No, I actually haven't.
What kind of controller would name an engine something like Smudger? What was a Smudger engine like?
According to Duke, he was very reckless and roguelike. He had at least 500 accidents or spills while on the Mid-Sodor Railway, and he became so dangerous that the manager turned him into a generator.
A generator? How awful.
That sounds a lot like Godred.
Godred? Do you mean the king?
No, the engine from the Caldyfell Railway.
Oh, I've heard of Godred. I think you've told me about him before, just don't remember when you told me, that's all.
Well, it was Caldy who I heard it from. Anyway, he was a reckless engine and never cared about safety. Then one day he was coming down yon mountain when he slipped and rolled down the mountain. Just like that. He was never repaired.
How tragic. Wait, you don't think that Godred and Smudger were the same?
The same engine? Rubbish!
Now, he did have a good theory, but I highly doubt that, Jock.
So, what's the final verdict of Smudger?
I don't know. Nobody does. For now, Smudger is a huge mystery.
I knew there was something strange about the engine. Who knows what other secrets he has?
Grandpuff, can I ask you something?
Why, yes, Falcon. What does he inquire?
Well, we were just curious, but could you tell us the whole tale of Smudger? Everyone's looking for him, and I'd like to know what happened.
Smudger? Oh yes, that insolent little green goblin. Very well. That engine arrived in the year 1897.
We have a new engine coming from Fletcher and Jennings. Please give him a warm welcome.
Yes, sir.
Well, it's about time we got another engine.
Hello, you must be the new engine. I'm Albert.
And my name is Crimson. You know, like the colour, isn't it obvious?
They call me Smudge, and you must be Duke. Ah, yes, I know all about you. Named after the Duke of Sodor. Such a big honor. Can I call you Dookie?
Dookie? I don't know if my grace would have approved.
Very well then, Brown Buster. Now where's my work? Come on, I've already been too bored today.
Quite an eager sort, isn't he?
That's the trait of a really useful engine. I was never more wrong in my entire life. It was very bouncy and became extremely reckless.
Oh, Bob! Fiddlesticks!
Jesus Christ, are you riding drunk or something?
Swag. That's what I've got. Swag.
Swag isn't welcome here, rail gangster.
Come on, chill, Dookie. I ain't causing no harm.
I remember one incident in particular. He had to rail like usual.
Listen, Dookie, who worries about a few spills?
We do here, Mr. Rotten Rider.
Rotten Rider? Come on, Dookie, chill, man.
I am not ice cream. I do not simply chill. Get your act together, youngster, or there will be severe consequences.
Ugh, you know what you are, Grandpa Puffer? You're nothing but a stinking old...
I will not repeat what he called me that day, as this must remain PG. That is it. I have hired you, Smudger. Be as reckless as you like. And don't come trying to meet with a manager. And sure enough, one day, I came back to the station where I saw Smudger with swarms of angry people. I think I might have seen police among them. What happened?
I don't know, Duke. But good lord, this commotion seems as if someone's been murdered!
The next day, I came into the shed and the manager was finishing up a conversation with Smudger.
We will make you useful at last.
Smudger stopped laughing then. And in the spring of 1902, Smudger was turned into a generator and put it at the back of the shed.
And I remember he was there for a few years, then just disappeared one day.
Exactly!
I wonder what happened to the little fellow.
Hello, everyone. Sorry, I just got very nervous all of a sudden. My head's not been quite right, if you know what I mean.
We were talking about that engine the Railway Society's looking for.
Oh, really? What's this engine's name?
You probably don't know him. His name was Smudger. Bertram's face suddenly fell, and he started sweating.
Smudger, eh? You mean that green engine who was extremely reckless and was turned into a generator?
Yes, exactly!
Wait a minute. I know about him.
I remember seeing him as a generator on the Mid-Sodor Railway.
Bertram, you arrived over 20 years after Smudger disappeared.
Exactly, Bertram.
Bertram, is everything all right?
Yes, I'm fine. Just,
You're not fine. You're shaking violently. Have you got a secret tip?
Calm down, Duke. He just had a traumatic accident.
Come on, spit it out, boy.
You're acting very odd, Duke.
I said spit it out, Bertram! Or is that what I should call you?
Yes, that's my name. And there's nothing to, spit out, Dookie.
Leave him alone, Duke.
Just a minute! Legends, call me!
Leave him alone.
Quiet, Stuart! I think we finally solved the mystery of the disappearance of Smudger.
What on earth are you talking about?
He's with us. He's always been.
He's right there!
Rubbish, Duke. Just rubbish. How is that physically possible?
No, it's true. I was rebuilt into that brown tank engine on the Scarlowy Railway. I wasn't taken legally, though. In other words, I was stolen by some workmen and given to the quarry company on the Scarlowy Railway.
Of course, that couldn't make more sense. You lost your memory, so that's why we've never heard about it.
I don't believe it. They saved you, but not me! You, who are a complete abomination! You, who are rude, foul-mouthed little green gangster! You do not deserve to be saved! You have no right to still exist!
I'm sorry. I've changed now.
It makes no difference!
Stop bullying him, Grandpuff! He's changed now!
He's right. I have changed.
What you called me on that day never left me.
I'm so sorry, Duke.
I spent decades in this shed while you puffed happily around up to your wretched mischief.
That's enough, Duke!
Come back, Bertram.
Oh no you don't! I'm not finishing you!
No one chases engines on this line.
There you are! What on earth are you doing? Oh, I see. Coward! Do you honestly think taking your own life will solve anything?
That's funny. A little while ago, you said he had no right to live.
Stay out of this!
No, we won't.
I said stay-
Duke of Sodor, if you lay one buffer on Bertram, you will be disgraced forever!
Duke was the oldest, and was named after his grace, the Duke of Sodor.
That would never suit his grace!
But they got very tired of hearing all about his grace, his grace, his grace, his grace.
Grace. His grace. His grace would not approve of my behavior.
Help! The bridge is going to collapse!
Don't worry, my dear Duke. We'll get you to safety.
SMUDGER would not have done that. SMUDGER would not have rescued Scarlet from the gunpowder thieves. But SMUDGER was only careless. He wasn't malicious. He was just an idiot.
Do you want to know why I was so reckless? My driver and fireman were alcoholics. Back then, they would always blame everything on the engine. Since I was with them every day, their behavior gave me a negative influence. The reason I was turned into a generator was because one day, my driver accidentally pulled the regulator too soon, and I ran over and killed the passenger. They found out it was my crew, and that they were at fault, and they were handled accordingly. But people refused to go on the railway if I still ran on it. They wanted me to be destroyed, but the manager had sympathy for me. So he decided to just make me useful in another way. He never told you the truth because he was afraid to damage the railway's reputation.
A driver is an engine's biggest influence. Why didn't you tell anyone they were alcoholics?
Because I was afraid. They said I would be sorry if I did. I should have told someone, though, because the abuse that I experienced ruined my life. I felt so guilty afterwards, even when I was rebuilt into that brown tank engine. I've never told anyone this, but as often as I've crossed over this bridge, I've thought about what it'd be like to fall off it and disappear.
Good lord! Did you purposely try to fall off of it that night?
That night? No. I just got caught on it. A very bad coincidence.
You mean you thought about committing suicide?
Look at you now, and I don't see Smudger. I never did. I was just so shocked, and I don't know what came over me.
I was an extremely reckless and rude engine. I understand why.
But that was it! You were just a huge jerk, not a murderer or a criminal! And I remember when you first arrived, you were just a bouncy little engine who was eager to work. That is the quality of a really useful engine. And now you act exactly like you did when you first arrived in the Mid-Star Railway. Always strive for perfection in your jobs.
Duke, I'm sorry for calling you that hideous insult.
That was over 100 years ago. I think I can let it slide. I'm sorry about the way I acted. You have so much to live for, Smudger.
Please, don't call me that anymore. Smudger is gone. Smudger got his punishment. I am Bertram, the old warrior.
Guess we better go tell Brackley the truth.
Yes, but let's wait a little while.
With all these mysteries having the most unexpected answers, I now think my whole life is a lie.
But at least you've got a whole lot to write in your book.
Yes, indeed. Although, why do they call him the Old Warrior?
Because he was the founder of basketball.
Really?
No, I actually have no idea why.
The four friends puffed home as the sun began to set. Christmas was coming very soon, and they were all excited as ever. Also, two big mysteries had been solved.
I know it's early, but Merry Christmas, everyone!
Merry Christmas, Dookie! I mean Merry Christmas, Your Grace!
Your Grace? I don't think I deserve that amount of honor! Merry Christmas, Bertram. I'm glad to have you on this railway.